Dizzy, o que te atrai tanto no Brasil, capaz de trazer aqui pela quinta vez?
Well, from the very first time in 1956, I felt comfortable. You know, I didn't feel like a stranger. This is the only country outside of the United States that have come to that makes me feel like I'm one of them.
Mm-hmm. Dizzy, por que o apelido? Dizzy.
Well, I was always the most intelligent musician in our circle of musicians when I was in Philadelphia. It got stuck onto me in Philly. And they probably thought it was incongruous to call me something that was that far away from my true personality of being intelligent. It looks funny to say, hey, intellect. When it say, hey, dizzy, you know?
Okay.
So I guess they thought it was a joke. But it stuck.
Thank you. Quando você, juntamente com Charlie Parker e Thelonious Monk, criou o bebop, você sabia que estava revolucionando o jazz?
Evolution, not revolution. We had before I met Charlie Parker, we had a little thing going in New York, and then I met Charlie Parker, and that really set it up, because he was playing differently. And they were playing differently, but we had the rhythm and the harmony and the show part of the music, and he had the style. Mm-hmm. So we merged those, and that's what happened to be bebop.
Você mergulha fundo no pop e no funk. O que te levou a isso?
Well, to prove that it was no different from our music, that was played, it's the same music. It's just developed on another line, you know? So it's the same thing. It's no big deal, you know? Forward, because rock is all mixed up with Latin music and jazz and blues. So it didn't make sense. So I thought I would try to do something to get the kids to know me, who I am, and what I stand for. So it worked out pretty good. It's doing very well in the United States now.
Everything. Love. makes me treat you the way that I do. Gee, baby, ain't I good to you?
Você não acha que corre o risco de ser acusado de estar se comercializando, como frequentemente ocorre com os músicos que transcendem a fronteira do jazz?
I hope so. I hope it's true. I hope they say that I'm accused of playing commercial music. I hope it's true, because commercial means money. So if you want to make money, you have to do what the people want. You just can't. You can't. Jam it down people's throats.
E essa pedra que você sempre usa, o que significa?
This stone is a talisman. It comes from the Holy Land, which is Israel. It comes from the shrine of the Baal. One of our prophets is buried there under this golden dome. And this rest of it is Mount Carmel. And they got a lot of rocks around. So a Baha'i was on pilgrimage, picked up one of the rocks, looked at it and said, and took it back and made, put gold around it.
Você sempre tem músicos jovens, ainda desconhecidos, tocando com você, né, nos seus grupos. Isso é uma forma de procurar uma renovação musical?
That is. That is. That's exactly what it is. I've always been surrounded by young musicians. I've been playing with young and old, but a lot of young musicians because I get sustenance from these young guys. They have such
energy.
Yeah, yes. So I had a good time. Make you play too, man. push.
Thank you.
Diz, você tem algum recado para os nossos amigos do jazz que estão assistindo?
Well, I would say that the Brazilian musicians are contributing to the evolution of our music. Music probably would do it before, but the earth one day will be unified. So the Brazilians are doing things now to help unify the music of the Western Hemisphere.
Play on, put down, ooh, pow, ooh.